The occasion was officiated by Speaker Rebecca Kadaga, who noted that the creation of new districts and an administrative unit constrains both government and parliament programs respectively. Kadaga further advised government to amend the Public Procurement and Disposal Unit Act to allow government projects start on time.
We have been talking about the delays to projects of the government. This is a living example. How can you do a procurement for over 2 years? 2 years. One procurement. Objections, this, that. Honourable members, Prime Minister, I think we need to review this process. There are even people who just do mischief. Therefore, just do mischief. Go to court, wasting time. I think we need to review the process. Otherwise, we are wasting time of the Ugandans and wasting opportunities.
The eight-storied building at the cost of 287 billion shillings is to house chambers of 500 MPs and other offices, including archive services, members' lounge, a library, a dining hall, committee rooms, and press lounge. The current chambers were designed for only 80 members of parliament, but it is now housing over 400 members of parliament. Meanwhile, the Minister of Works and Transport, Monica Azubantega, warned the contractors, Roco Construction Limited, to mind the quality of work at the site.
Now, to Roco, I want to caution you that this building is a national building. It will house the members of parliament, very important people in the country, and therefore it should be of the highest standards and quality, and will stand the test of time.
The construction process is expected to take 3 years, and the contractors, represented by the managing director, Mark, have promised to put together their best expertise to contribute to the development of Uganda as they employ local manpower and use local materials.
We are fully aware of the importance of this job and the time constraints it comes along with. We have put together our best expatriate and local engineers and technicians together with the right equipment and plant to execute this job.
These have worked on several magnificent buildings like Mapera House, Akasha Mall, Namugongo Shrine, NSSF House, Bank of Uganda, among others. Report by Richard Nakasi for Urban TV.